Thank you to my YouTube members who saw this video before everyone else. Hello friends, if I asked the Roblox developer community what their opinion is on Roblox's terrain system, I'd get pretty mixed responses, but we would all be in agreement that it is by no means perfect, or even that good. It's slow, it's too simple and unrealistic, it doesn't give you enough materials, and all of them just aren't that great quality. As my previous video showed, most people don't even know that it has properties that you can change in the properties panel. Quite a lot of people have asked me how I make my terrain look realistic, and I suppose it shouldn't really come to a surprise that I use very minimal terrain from Roblox's terraining tools. Instead, I mainly use meshes with realistic texture maps, like these. These are all pieces of realistic terrain that I keep in my realistic nature file. So then how exactly do you go from this to this? Or this? These are all realistic Roblox build showcases that I have made over the past 5 years, and they are all playable and you can visit them on my profile. Fun fact, the main audience of my games are roleplayers. And speaking of roleplayers, I'd like to talk about a certain Roblox roleplay group real quick before we start with this week's video. You already know that I want to support other developers and their work, and this week's video is kindly being sponsored by the entire country of Belgium. I'm just kidding, it's a roleplay group called Belgium. This roleplay group is full of action and drama, there's never a quiet day in Belgium apparently. God. This Discord roleplay group hosts all kinds of roleplays in the Belgian city of Rotswelde. I assume that's how you pronounce it. I did German and only for 3 years. Things from daily citizen life to the duties of aristocracy, there's in-game police, political parties, royalty, and more. The other day, some kind of attack happened at the Rotswelde Plaza with the police being involved. Total drama island right here. Oh, also, while I was exploring their Discord server, I found out that there's actually loads of these countries, and they all have announcement boards in the server of Belgium. And Venezuela is in absolute shambles right now, go figure. I absolutely love a bit of fun and chaos in a controlled environment, and the roleplay group of Belgium is a great place to get involved with a community with all kinds of interesting positions you can enter. The wonderful community of Belgium will be linked in the description for you to check out. And even if roleplay groups isn't something that interests you, it's still good to at least word your support for this small dev team and spread the word to people that you think might like it. When Roblox life seems boring, go to Belgium. I don't know why I said that. Thank you, Belgium, for sponsoring this week's video. That sounds so funny to say. And thank you, the viewer, for not skipping this ad. If you want to promote your work, the Google Doc with all of the information will be linked in the description. Now back to the video. Ow! Now, you'd be forgiven in thinking that using a floating ball to make terrain grow is simpler, easier, and better than having to deal with the emotional torment of having to manually place hundreds of terrain meshes. But yeah, it probably is. But is it worth it? Is it worth having to deal with the boring, plain, uninspired Roblox terrain of the beautifully gorgeous, realistic PDR mesh placing terrain approach? God, I can already hear that one smooth brain, money and numbers obsessed chump calling out.
But Hollows Holly, using PBR meshes is way more likely than using Roblox's terrain tools.
Ha! Wrong! Wrong! How does it feel knowing that you have been lied to? How does it feel knowing that everything you know about Roblox terraining has been a lie? A little tattletale. And I know who by as well. I find it so entertaining to watch a builder lie simply because he can't fathom the idea of his build not being perfect. The amount of times I've said to builders in hidden devs, if you union that and transfer it to a mesh, it'll fix your z-ficing issue on maintaining the scale of your parts. And then they've had an absolute panic attack saying, yeah, I knew that, but I chose to do it this way because if I union this model, my game will explode and corrupt. But when I've told a builder that he needs to lower the vibrance of one of the colors in his build because it's too eye straining for the player, and then he says, yeah, I know color theory. I'm more than capable of making good color combinations. I'm a pro at it, actually. I've been doing it for 3 years. This is just the style of this build. You're seething and molding at a woman giving you building advice, but sure, man.
Alright guys, it's time to share my work in one of these discords. I don't know what to expect.
Unfortunately, this is just what Roblox developers do. I mean, think about it. The typical age range of Roblox developers seems to be between 13 and 18. In my experience with Roblox developers in Discord communities, the average age seems to be around 17. So, teenagers. And not just any old teenager.
boy teenagers, all with something to prove, all wanting to appear like they know their stuff, and all more than happy to judge others if it means making their work and themselves look more professional and better. And so if someone comes along and criticizes it, especially a cis woman like me, the number one thing they tend to default to is to try and convince me why I'm wrong. Whenever I see a guy making a river like this, I'll always ask him if he's tried using PBR meshes to terrain instead, and he will always say to me, "Yes, I have. I've done it before, I know how to do it well, but I prefer it this way." And then when I'll ask why, he'll get a little defensive and come up with a reason along the lines of, "It's too laggy." And then when I tell him it's not less laggy, his smooth brain now just assumes I'm personally attacking him, and will then proceed to say something along the lines of, "Ew, you're too old to be developing on Roblox, go back to the kitchen." Am I right, guys? And then all the other teenagers are too afraid to back me up because they're scared of being called a simp. What a horrid community we've made for ourselves.
Like, 90% of the people with a voice actor role don't actually voice act. So, take away the voice actor role and she has no talent. That sucks.
God, there's a helicopter flying overhead. So, is using meshes to terrain less laggy than using Roblox's terrain tools? Yes! Well, sort of. If you're making terrain as realistic as mine, it's obviously going to be more laggy than this. That being said, if you're using Roblox's terrain tools to make large maps such as those used in those animal roleplay games like Creatures of Scenario, Warrior Cats, and most notably Prior Extinction, whose admin I discovered watches my videos, and so I will be personally attacking this game today. Hi Stego, I love the game, but your terrainers need to get it together. Anyways, if you're planning on making a large map with lots of terrain, Roblox's terrain tools is actually not so much of a good idea. There's quite a few reasons for this, but the main one is LOD. For those who don't know, LOD, or level of detail, is very common in pretty much every game engine, including Roblox, and it affects the detail of meshes depending on many factors. When people talk about LOD in Roblox, they're talking about it in the context of LOD distance. This is a mesh, and you can see that when I get further away from it, it starts to change shape. This is Roblox purposefully reducing the amount of triangles and the quality of the texture based on the distance. We don't need to see all of those details when we're so far away, and obviously less detail means less lag. If you want to play around with LOD and make it even less laggy, you can change that in the mesh's properties. You have full control over how your mesh renders and subsequently how laggy or how not laggy you want it to be. You want to know where you don't have any control over this? That's right, Roblox's terrain tools. I mean, they do have LODs as well, however they are objectively worse. They look worse, they don't perform as well, you can't control how they behave at all. The only way you can possibly control them a little is in the graphics settings, but that's user end. You still have no control over it, bozo. You know what else you can't manipulate with Roblox's terrain tools that's essential to performance? Collisions. No matter if you plan for the player to touch them or not, Roblox's terrain is always collidable. That means you can walk on it. And when the engine has to calculate physics and collisions for the player, even when they aren't actively touching it, it still will cause lag. And I have seen cases where physics scripts have been the sole purpose for lag when placed in an experience with Roblox terrain. What the hell, Roblox? With meshes, you not only have control whether you can walk on a mesh or not, but you can also control the collision fidelity. This is essentially how accurate a collision is. I recommend you watch this video to learn more about it, as we already have too much to go through in this video. But long story short, turn can collide off on meshes you don't need players touching, and collision fidelity should be set to box on all meshes with can collide off. Congrats, you just gained a frame. Well done. There are many other ways in which meshes are way more performant than Roblox's terrain, such as meshes not rendering behind walls and stuff, but the final most outrageous thing about Roblox's terrain is triangles. Look at this flat piece of grass. This is essentially a cube with round edges. How many triangles would you expect it to be? 12 for each of the faces, and let's say 100 for the rounded edges? So about 112 triangles, right? Well, if you multiplied it by 100, yes. What in the holy heaven of Shedletsky am I looking at? Thousands, thousands of triangles for a flat plane. This flat surface literally only needs two triangles, but it has thousands. And yes, Roblox obviously expects you to raise and lower parts of this plane, and those triangles give leeway for you to do that. But what if you don't want to do that? There are so many times where you really don't need all of those triangles. They're a waste and they do nothing but cause needless lag. And then of course you can't turn collisions off on them, so Roblox has to calculate the physics of every single thousand of them. You'll be more than thrilled to know that Roblox LODs still render these useless triangles, and even if you avert your eyes from this absolute monstrosity, they're still being rendered.
Boy, using Roblox's terrain system is so much less laggy than using meshes.
God, builders from hidden devs suck. Now I want to clarify something. It would be hypocritical of me to make fun of Roblox's terrain this much without being transparent with you. I do use Roblox's terrain. In fact, I use it in pretty much all of my showcases. I've used it in Renekild, I used it in Renave, it took up a very significant part of Sanctuary. However, these days, I only ever tend to use Roblox's terrain to complement my existing mesh terrain. As you can see here in Sixth Stop, this part is all mesh terrain and this part is Roblox terrain. The only reason I'm making a video about this is because people just use Roblox's terrain way too much. I'm looking at you, Prior Extinction. When terraining with meshes objectively looks better and performs better, I really do not see why these big maps in particular like to use Roblox's terrain exclusively and nothing else. It's a shame because it's so memory intensive and a lot of people are missing out because of it. That being said, I'd love to start a discussion, so please consider joining my Discord server so that we can talk about this further. I don't know if you could tell, but this video was meant to be something completely different. It was originally going to be a tutorial on realistic terrain and I would have showed you my workflow and we would have made something together, but unfortunately I'm just objectively terrible at writing scripts. And what was originally a bit of just making fun of Roblox's terrain system turned into an enormous event that lasted 10 minutes. And so to include the terrain tutorial would mean doubling the length of this video, which means I wouldn't be able to release it on time. And also I caught a cold during this whole editing process and so I had to take a few days off as well. Long story short, but basically what you're watching right now is only 50% of the video that I have made, and the remaining 50% of it will be released Friday next week at 6 o'clock GMT. And in the meantime, I hope that this video was stimulating for you in looking at a different perspective for terraining in Roblox. I want to thank my YouTube members again for their infinite patience with this one, especially since I've had a cold and this one had to come out a little later than most videos do. You're all amazing. Continue to be kind and uplifting to others, and I will see you Friday next week. Thank you very much, and goodbye. Bye.